एक्स्ट्रा टाइम।
द पिच हियर इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू हेल्प द स्पिनर बट नो ग्रेट अमाउंट ऑफ स्विंग इज एक्सपेक्टेड हियर सो मे आई नो योर ओपिनियन ऑन द इफेक्ट ऑफ द पिंक बॉल नॉट स्विंगिंग दैट मच।
I don't think that's a very accurate assessment. I think the pink ball does tend to swing a lot more than the normal red ball that we play with. We experienced that in the one match that we played in 2019 against Bangladesh. It's much more challenging to play with the new ball, with the pink ball, regardless of what pitch you're playing on. And especially in the evening, if, say, you're as a batting team, you're starting your innings in the evening under lights, then that one and a half hours is very challenging. Yes, spin will come into play for sure, but I don't think the new ball and the fast bowlers can be ignored. The pink ball does bring them into the game till the ball is nice and shiny, and something that we are very well aware of, and we're preparing accordingly.
I just want to know, you have such a variety, varied bowling attack, very different personalities and characters in the bowling department. On one hand, you have something like Ashwin, quite an analyzer, and tends to take a lot and prepare a lot and analyze a lot. And then there's Ishant, who says that he's really not into thinking so much and likes to keep things simple. So can you talk about how you handle or how you deal with these kind of varied personalities, two different opposites in the sense?
This is part of man management that you have to do as a captain. It's very important to understand that you need to bring the most aggressive option out of your bowlers at all times. And how to communicate to each individual is very important. What I speak to Ishant will probably bring the best out of him in terms of looking for wickets and, bowling attacking lines. At the same time, we would discuss fields. Ash is very smart, very sharp, and he understands his field positioning and all those kind of things very well. But sometimes I do chip in as a batsman and say, if you were bowling to me, I would not like a fielder here or here or here. So he understands that quite quickly, and he's very smart about it. So I think we've been able to develop a good communication, a good understanding over the years, and that's one of the big reasons for the bowling unit bowling together, understanding the plans clearly, and having an aggressive mindset wherever we have played in the world. And we've been picking 20 wickets continuously, and something that we take a lot of pride in as bowlers. Individuals are different, but the goal remains common, which is to get the other team out as quickly as possible, and in order to do that, they bowl really well in partnerships and understand their strengths and their field positioning very well.
Virat, obviously you are going to play a test match under lights and with pink ball. So what are the adjustments that you have to do in your game?
Well, last time we experienced that for the first session is probably the nicest to bat, when the sun's out and the ball doesn't do as much. But when it starts to get dark, especially during that twilight period, it gets very tricky. The light changes, it's difficult to sight the ball, and then under lights is like playing the first session in the morning. In a normal test match, the ball does tend to swing a lot. So I think it's a reversal of roles and something that you need to adjust to quite quickly as batsmen. Even though you might be set in the afternoon, but you have to really take guard again and start from scratch in the evening, and understand that you probably have to be a bit more disciplined, than you were in the day when things were probably easier with the bat. So these are the major differences. And similarly with the bowlers, the plan in the afternoons was to bowl a nice and consistent line and length, and then in the evenings when the situation allowed us to, we attacked a lot more. So I think the same kind of template will be useful in this game as well, and these are the few differences from a normal test match scenario that we experience.
I just wanted to ask you about the record of MSD you are gunning for as a captain to become the most successful test captain at home. Personally, what does that really mean to you, and how do you take things when a record approaches?
That record means nothing to me. Records are something that are looked at from an individual point of view, and that's not what we play sport for. Whether it's individual records as a batsman or whether it's the number of wins as a captain, I'm doing a responsibility to the best of my abilities and my potential, and an absolute commitment for the team for so many years, and I would continue to do so till the time I play this game. So I'm just fulfilling my responsibility none of the records are meant to be forever. These are very fickle things which probably look great from the outside comparing to individuals, and that's something that, you know, people on the outside love to do all the time. But that really doesn't matter to any of us, to be very honest, because the mutual respect and understanding and camaraderie that you have as teammates or, you know, your ex-captain is something that you hold really closely to your heart, and I understand the importance and, you know, the significance of that. So that is going always going to be way more important in my life than, you know, these milestones or these records. As I said, I'm doing my responsibility to keep Indian cricket on top, and I will continue to do so. And that should be the mindset of everyone playing for the team. And whoever in you know, few years down the line, whoever the next person who leads this team, you know, should take Indian cricket forward as well. So yeah, I don't really pay attention to any other records. I'm not even aware of them when I step onto the field, to be honest. I'm told afterwards.
Virat, Joe Root has said that if conditions are more seam oriented, Indian England players will have an edge. Looking at how they struggled against the spin in the second test, and the pink ball is known to help seamers. Now, you also mentioned it earlier in the PC. Now, how will you look to ensure that India don't give an inch to the wasting pink in the pink ball test?
By doing what we've been doing for years now, which is playing good cricket, our focus will solely remain on our team. Not really bothered about what the strengths and weaknesses of the English team are. We beaten them in their home as well, where the ball does way more, and we have bowled them out every time. So we're not really bothered with that. It's just about, you know, playing well as a team. And yeah, there are many weaknesses in the opposition's side as well. If you are keen to exploit them, things can. If the seamer friendly track is for them, it's for us as well. And we probably have, you know, among other teams, the best bowling attack in the world. So we're not really bothered by what the ball might bring differently to the table. We're ready for anything that comes our way.
Regarding the World Test Championship scenario, the next two tests, of course, you know, not just fate of India, but also fate of England and Australia hang. So how do you look at this scenario, and what are your thoughts? Do we have a little bit more comfort because we just have one test to win and the other to draw?
You can't play for those kind of reasons. We're not looking to win one and draw one. We're looking to win both. For us, these are two games of cricket, and solely the only thing that we're focused on. What it does afterwards is a conversation for later. That's a reality that's not present right now. In the present moment, we are preparing for tomorrow, ready for the grind for 5 days, wanting to win a test match for India and then move on to the next one. One day at a time is something that we've followed for years now, and there's no point running far ahead into the future where you have no idea what's going to happen. So we are going to focus on what we can do as individuals in the present moment, and let other people think of scenarios and what if not, and we're really not focused on those things.
England were bowled out for 58 in their most recent day-night test, and India for 36 even more recently. Will those experiences help or hinder the thought process going into this game?
No. According to me, no. Both are bizarre experiences for two quality sides. If you ask England the same question, do you think that, you know, you could be bowled out for 50 again? Their answer probably would be no, because you understand that on that particular day, things just are meant to happen a certain way, and whatever you try to do, it's out of your control, and nothing seems to go right. And exactly what happened to us in Adelaide as well. Barring that 45 minutes of bad cricket, we dominated that test match as well. So we're very confident in terms of how we played the pink ball. Even in Australia, where the pitches were assisting their seamers, they were under the pump through that Adelaide game, and that 45 minutes where we were just blown away. There was literally nothing to come back into the game with. So yeah, we understand that quite well. From the outside, things are not as detailed or explained what happens in the change room, what the mindset of individuals is, but you understand exactly what went wrong on that day. And you brush it aside, which the team did beautifully afterwards from Melbourne test. And, you know, ended up making a great comeback. So, these are experiences for sure. Not a hindrance, not something that is a mental scar, but something that you learn from, you move ahead, and you keep improving as cricketers and understand, you know, if it's a difficult situation again, how to apply yourself and probably get out of that tough situation.
Virat, hi. Virat, given the enormity of the stadium, and about 50,000 fans are expected to turn up. Do you think the whole atmosphere could be a little intimidating for the England players, especially those who have been touring India for the first time?
Yeah, I think so. Crowd plays a massive role. The crowds really get behind us, and the difference of which we saw in the second test, you know, the opposition does feel the pressure when you go to play in Australia, England, South Africa, New Zealand, anywhere. I've experienced that as a batsman, when you walk into the field and 30,000 fans are booing you or, you know, clapping when the bowler's running into bowl, it does play on your head. So we would love for that atmosphere to be present, you know, make life more difficult for the opposition and really get behind the team. That's what playing at home is all about. It's not only about the conditions on the field, but 50,000 people and their energy behind your team, it does push you in the right direction and it does put a lot more pressure on the opposition.
Virat, Ishan will be playing his 100th test match. You know, past few years, last 4-5 years, I've seen him become a new bowler altogether. What has been the one change or changes that you have seen in him, and what has been your influence in as a captain on him sort of rediscovering his mojo or going on to play 100 test matches now?
Look, I've known Ishan for many years now. He started playing state cricket with me from his first season onwards. We've been roommates for many years in state cricket, Ranji Trophy cricket. When he got selected for India, he was fast asleep in the afternoon and I had to kick him off the bed to say that you've been selected, and he wouldn't believe me. So that's how far we go back, and I couldn't be happier for him. For playing 100 test matches as a fast bowler is no mean feat, and especially playing in our conditions where things can get so difficult, but he persevered, he kept working hard, and that's been his essence from day one. Very hardworking guy, very honest about the game, about his abilities, about what he can bring to the table, and very self-assured. I was most excited to you know, work with him and really bring the best out of him as an attacking fast bowler. And something that, you know, it clicked immediately because he knew my mindset. He knows me inside out. There's big trust factor. I know him inside out. I know that he's going to respond to advice. He knows I'm gonna listen to his plans as well. So I think it's worked really well for both of us, not just for him as a fast bowler, but for me as a captain as well, to have that kind of experience and, you know, the kind of consistency he brings in with the attacking lines and lengths he bowls. I've just been very, very happy to see him really enjoy his bowling in the last 4 or 5 years and really become that stalwart of, you know, the Indian fast bowling group. So couldn't be happier for him. Really, really excited. I'm going to be present on the field when he plays his 100th game, and you know, to see that smile on his face and just run in and bowl will be great to watch for a dear friend of mine.
Virat, you have some good memories with pink ball test match in India. Last time against Bangladesh, you scored a century as well. Is that it in your head that you know what is ahead of you?
No, I treated that as any other game of cricket and just fulfill my responsibility to go and score runs for the team. That's why I'm selected in the first place as a batsman in this team. And that's my responsibility. And I'll continue to do that, whether you play with the pink ball, red ball, white ball. Those things don't matter. They're probably irrelevant for me and have been for a long time. For me, it's all about what can I do for the team in that situation. And the focus only remains that. Ended up being a good game. Sometimes, when you've played so much red ball cricket as well, but it's not certain that you score every time and it's not certain that you fail every time. So cricket is a game to be played in the present moment, and I'm certainly well prepared for this test match as well, and I'll give my absolute best to contribute for my team.
ये अब तक हम चर्चा करते रहे हैं कि MCG सबसे बड़ा स्टेडियम है, एक अलग तरह का वहाँ पर वातावरण होता है, माहौल होता है जब क्रिकेट होता है. अब ये कितना प्राउड है एज एन इंडियन, एज ए क्रिकेटर, कि इंडिया के पास दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा क्रिकेट स्टेडियम है और उसमें आप पहला मैच खेलने जा रहे हैं. और एक और चीज इसी से जुड़ा हुआ है कि जो सीट्स है यहाँ पर, मैंने देखा ऑरेंज कलर की है और पिंक बॉल से मैच होगा, क्या इससे कोई फर्क पड़ेगा जब बैट्समैन वहां पर अगर आप खेल रहे हैं तो?
पहले मैं दूसरे सवाल का जवाब मैं आपको दे सकता हूँ. साइड स्क्रीन हमारा काफी ब्रॉड है और जो सीट्स हैं वो एक ऐसे एंगल पे हैं जहाँ पे प्रॉब्ली आपका ध्यान नहीं जाता है एज अ बैट्समैन. एज अ फील्डिंग ग्रुप हमने इस बारे में डिस्कशन करी है, बट जिस तरीके से मैं इस चीज़ को देखता हूँ कि सीट का कलर जो है वो है, आप उसको बदल नहीं सकते हैं. बॉल के कलर और सीट के कलर में फर्क है, और अगर आप ध्यान से बॉल पे फोकस करेंगे तो आई थिंक बॉल को पिक करने में कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी. हमने प्रैक्टिस भी करी है दिन में और शाम को दोनों, तो कोई इश्यूज नहीं हमें फेस हुए. और पहला सवाल जो आपने पूछा, हमारे लिए काफ़ी गर्व की बात है कि सबसे ज़्यादा कैपेसिटी वाला स्टेडियम दुनिया में इंडिया में है, और हम पहला टेस्ट मैच खेलने वाले हैं उस पर. और एटमॉस्फेयर जब लोग आएंगे, स्टेडियम भरेंगे, वो एक्सपीरियंस उसके बाद ही आप एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं. लेकिन जो हमने देखा है अभी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वाइज और जो फैसिलिटीज़ प्रोवाइडेड हैं, जैसा स्टेडियम बनाया गया है, जैसे एरियाज डेजिग्नेटेड हैं, कमाल का स्टेडियम बनाया है. और हम लोग काफ़ी एक्साइटेड हैं, काफ़ी खुश हैं कि इतना बढ़िया, इतना सुंदर स्टेडियम हमारे देश में बना और हम उस पर खेलने जाएंगे कल से.
লেটেস্ট নিউজ আর এক্সক্লুসিভ ভিডিওর সঙ্গে আপডেট থাকতে এখনই সাবস্ক্রাইব করুন আমাদের ইউটিউব চ্যানেল, বেল আইকনে ক্লিক করতে ভুলবেন না জানো.